Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel on PLC programming using CODESYS. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create communication between two CODESYS PLCs using network variables. I hope you enjoy watching this video and make sure to like the video, write a comment, share the video with your network, and check out my roadmap document if you haven't done it yet. Thanks for watching. Let's get started. Here you can see what we are going to have at the end of the tutorial. The visualization windows for two PLCs, PLC01 and PLC02, are shown. When I change the value of a boolean or an integer variable on the PLC01 side, there are variables on the PLC02 side that follow them. Similarly, there are variables in the PLC01 side which follow the variables in the PLC02. These two PLCs are communicating using network variable lists, and we are going to learn how this could happen. I started by creating a standard project with CODESYS control win x64 as the device. To create the network variable, I right-click on the application and choose Add Network Variable Sender. This will create a global variable list for which I need to specify a name and declare some variables. I use mvl_send_PLC01 as the name and UDP as the network type. I keep the default settings as you can see here. I declare one integer and one boolean variable called ivar01PLC01 and bvar01PLC01. Then I add another instance of the same device, which will be running on a second PC. I also renamed the devices PLC01 and PLC02 to make it easier to distinguish them from each other later. For the second device, since it is not created as a standard project, we don't have all the elements in the device tree. Therefore, I removed the application in PLC02 and copied and pasted the application from the first device to the second device. On the other hand, for the second device, PLC02, I added the network variable receiver to the application. I call it nvl_rec_PLC02. You can see that there are two options to import the list of variables. The first option is to import it from PLC01, which is on the same network. The second option is to import it from a file. I choose the first option, and then we have the two variables imported to our network variable list. I will show you how to use the other option later. Then I added a visualization to PLC01 and placed a switch to change the value of the boolean variable and a dial to manipulate the value of the integer variable. On the other hand, I added a visualization to the second device, placed a lamp to show the state of the boolean variable, and a meter to display the value of the integer variable. I also place a label for each visualization to distinguish the two. Now I need to log in to both PLCs and download the code to each. When I scan the network, I can see the two PLCs listed. In my case, they are identical, but they could be different PLCs in general. First, I log in to the first PLC and run the project. Then I choose the second device in the toolbar, choose the right PLC on the network, log in and run the project. Now both PLCs are running the corresponding projects. Whenever I change the value of the variables in PLC01, the variables in PLC02 are updated. Please keep in mind that this is a one-way communication. Now I log out of the two PLCs and want to configure the network variables to send data from PLC02 to PLC01. For that, I add a network variable list sender to PLC02 and call it nvl_send_PLC02, choose UDP as the network type, and change the port value to 1204 as 1202 is already in use. Similarly, I include one integer and one boolean variable in the network variable list. Then I right-click on the created network variable, choose the properties, and in the Link to File tab, give a name to the file and determine a location for the file.
I should also choose the export before compile option to export the network variable list as a file to the chosen location, so I can load it later into the other PLC. Then I update the visualization of PLC02 by placing a push switch to change the Boolean variable and a potentiometer to modify the integer variable. I downloaded the project into PLC02 and ran it, and you can see that I can modify the value of those two variables. Now I need to switch to PLC01, add network variable list receiver, give it a name, and as the sender, I choose the import from file option. I need to select the same file that was created by the other PLC. Then we have the network variable list updated according to the information present in the file. I also update the visualization of PLC01 by placing a lamp and a meter to show the value of the two variables. Then I place the visualization windows from two PLCs beside each other for easier demonstration. Now the two PLCs are running the projects and exchanging the data with each other using the network variables. In conclusion, this is an easy way of creating a communication path between two or more CODESYS PLCs. However, we need to add separate network variable lists to have two-way communication. Furthermore, this is also specific to the CODESYS PLCs and not suitable for communicating with PLCs of other brands, as is the case with OPC UA, for example. Alright, that's all for this tutorial. I hope you have enjoyed watching this video. Please don't forget to subscribe to the channel, like the video, write a comment, and share the video with your network. Thanks for watching, and see you next time. Bye for now.